The Volkswagen emissions scandal just got worse for the automaker on Tuesday. It's set up to 11 million vehicles worldwide could be affected by software used to cheat emissions tests. As a German automaker continues to delve deeper into crisis, here's what we know so far. Number one, what is the scandal?
According to the EPA, Volkswagen has admitted that it has installed software on a controller in the car that regulates emissions from the tailpipe. And this software allows the car to turn on the emissions suppression when the car is being tested in the laboratory, but then turns it off when the car is out on the road.
The company issued a sweeping apology for breaching consumer trust over the weekend, but hasn't publicly admitted to manipulating test results. Chief Executive Martin Winterkorn has also issued a personal apology. Number two, the cars affected. Initially, the allegations concerned at least 480,000 Volkswagen diesel cars made since 2008. The Jetta, Beetle, Golf and Passat, and the Audi A3. But that is likely to change with the scandal now widening to 11 million cars.
And that could now include other models that have not yet been identified, such as the Skoda or Seat cars, which also are based on the same platform as the Passat.
Number three, the story in numbers. VW shares plunged as much as 20% on Monday in the wake of allegations. It fell another 23% on Tuesday morning. VW plans to take a $7.25 billion provision that will undoubtedly force the company to downgrade its earnings outlook. And the German automaker could face as much as $18 billion in fines for allegedly manipulating exhaust emissions tests. Number four, the U.S. Department of Justice has launched an investigation, said people familiar with the matter. The U.S. House Oversight and Investigations Subcommittee on Monday said it planned to hold a hearing in coming weeks. Meanwhile, lawyers filed a lawsuit seeking class action status against VW in a federal court in California that accused the company of fraudulent concealment, false advertising, and violating consumer rights. Number five, for Volkswagen, it's a rocky road ahead.
After the U.S. made its announcement on Friday, now it looks like the European Union is going to launch its own investigation. The Commission has called for a meeting of national regulators from around Europe to discuss Volkswagen and whether there should be an investigation of the entire auto industry to see if their emissions levels are also realistic.
Volkswagen's supervisory board, which oversees the company, will meet on Friday to discuss the emissions scandal, a person familiar with the situation said.